Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will discuss about chapter number 5 of research methods. What is critical contribution and how to develop hypothesis? The learning outcomes of the chapter are discuss the need for critical framework in deductive research, describe 4 main types of variables, and identify and label variables associated with any given situation. Develop a theoretical framework that includes all the relevant components. Develop a set of hypotheses to be tested. Demonstrate awareness of the role of the manager in the development of the theoretical framework. So basically, we will discuss about what is theoretical framework and how to develop hypotheses. Then we will discuss about the types of variables, for example, when we read research paper and business research and in the topic of business research, we will view and the variables like dependent variable, mediating variable, moderator variable, and control variables. So these are the objective of the chapter that we already discussed. Then we will discuss and we will focus on the theoretical framework and hypothesis generation. What is theoretical framework? A theoretical framework represents your belief on how certain phenomena, variables, and concepts are related with each other, and an explanation on why you believe that these variables are associated with each other. Means, if we are seeing that there is a relationship between salary increase and performance, so we have to justify this relationship with the help of theory and why these two variables are related with each other. If we explain these relationships with the help of any framework, with the help of any theory, that will be called a theoretical framework, that will be called a theoretical explanation. Theoretical framework includes steps: identify and label the variables correctly. Number one. Number two, state the relationships among the variables. Then we have to state the relationship between variables. For example, there is a positive relationship between salary increase and performance. There is a negative relationship between abusive supervision and performance. Explain how and why you expect these relationships. And number third is you have to explain why and how this relationship exists. Why you believe this relationship exists? For example, positive or negative relationship. Variables. Any concept or construct that varies or changes in value, that's called variable. In business search, there are main types of variables: independent, dependent variable, independent variable, moderator variable, and mediating variable or intervening variable. We will discuss each type in detail in coming slides. Independent variable, first of all, dependent variable is of primary interest to the researcher. Basically, the dependent variable is a primary research interest of the researcher. For example, one scholar or researcher want to investigate the employee performance. This will be primary interest of the scholar, that what variables are influencing the performance of the employees in XYZ organization. The goal of the research project is to understand, predict, or explain the variability in this variable. Independent variable influences the dependent variable DV in either positive or negative way. The variance in the DV is accounted for by IV. Means independent variable is a variable that influences the dependent variable. For example, a salary is independent variable and performance is dependent variable. So we can say that when salary increases, the performance will also increase if there is positive relationship between independent variables. Examples: a list of variables and labels them as dependent or independent variables, explaining why they are so labeled. Example one, an applied researcher want to increase the performance of organizational members in particular bank. So here, one of the example of independent and dependent variables are there. This is a figure which explains the relationship between independent and dependent variable. The independent variable here is new product success, and the dependent variable is stock market price. So the arrow shows the independent variable new product success is influenced to dependent variable stock market. So this figure explains the relationship between independent variables. This is example number two. Cross-cultural research indicates that managerial values govern the power distance between superior and subordinates. So here the example two explains the relationship between independent-dependent variable. In this example, power distance is dependent variable and managerial value is an independent variable. So we can say that this power distance is depending on managerial values. This diagram is also explaining the relationship that we discussed in previous slide, previous example. Managerial value is independent variable which influences to dependent variable power distance. This is another example. Although the relationship is true in general for all workers, but it is not true for workers who are not using the manual every time they need it. Thus, the interest and inclination of the workers is a moderating variable. So in this variable, we can explain, we can say that the relationship between two variables is depending on the third variable. Third variable is the person who are using manual and who are not using manual. This is an example of the moderating variable. Another example of the moderating variable is that, for example, we are investigating the relationship between salary increase and job performance. And if we say that the relationship between salary increase and performance, it depends on the gender. For male, the performance will be higher for males, and performance will be low for female or woman. The gender can be a moderating variable in any relationship. For example, in this figure, availability of reference manuals is independent variable, and number of rejections and number of reject is dependent variable, and the moderator is interest and inclination is moderator variable. So we can say that the relationship between availability of reference manuals and number of rejections will be increase or decrease. It depends on the interest and inclination. Moderators. Moderating variable, a moderator is a qualitative, gender, race, or quantitative level of reward variable that affects the direction or the strength of relation between independent variable. The definition of the moderator variable is that a variable which changes the strength of the relationship between independent and dependent variable is called moderating variable. The moderating variable is one that has a strong contingent effect in the dependent variable and dependent variable relationship. The presence of the moderating variable modifies the original relationship between independent variable. If a moderating variable is present in the relationship, then the relationship between dependent variable will be changed. It depends on the strength of the moderator. The relationship may be weak, the relationship may be strong. This is another example of the moderator variable. A prevalent theory is that the diversity of the workforce, according to the different ethnic origins, races, and nationalities, contributes more to organizational effectiveness because each group brings its own special expertise and skills to the workplace. This synergy can be exploited, however, only if managers know how to harness the special talents of the diverse group. Otherwise, they will remain untapped. So this is an example of the moderating variable. This is an explanation. This figure is also explained previous relationship. Independent variable here is workplace diversity, workforce diversity, and depending variable is dependent variable is organization effectiveness, and moderator is managerial expertise. So we can say that the relationship between workforce diversity and organization effectiveness is moderated by managerial experience, managerial expertise. And the relationship may be weak or may be strong. It depends on the managerial expertise. If expertise are very good, the relationship may be good. If the expertise are not good, the relationship may be weaker. Distinction between two variables, a difference between variables. Situation one, a research study indicates that the better of quality of the training programs is an organization and the greater the growth needs of the employees, where the need of the develop and grow on the job is strong. The greater is their willingness to learn new ways of doing things. So this is another example which explains the difference between variables. For example, the better the quality of the training programs is related to the greater is the willing to learn. Agar quality behtar hogi training programs ki, to jo respondents hain ya jo participants hain, unki willing jo hai wo bhi willingness increase ho sakti hai. The dependent variable is employees' willingness to learn. Here in this case, the dependent variable is the employees' willingness to learn, and then independent variable is training programs are growth, need, strength. Intervening variable. Intervening a mediating variable. What is the definition of the mediator? Mediator, a variable which explains the relationship between independent and dependent variable. And intervening a mediating variable is one that occurs between the dependent variable and dependent variables. It is caused by the independent variable and it is itself a cause of the dependent variable, not directly observable, but that link the independent and dependent variables. This is another example, in example 8, where a prevalent theory is example we already discussed in previous slides, so I think you can understand. Here is the dependent variable of organization effectiveness, and independent variable is workforce diversity, and intervening variable the surface of a function of diversity in the workforce creative synergy. This is an example of the mediating intervening variable. The intervening variable, this creative synergy results from the diverse workforce interacting and bringing together their expertise in problem solving. Note the creative synergy, the intervening variable surface at time 2 as a function of the workforce diversity which was in place at time 1 to bring about organizational effectiveness in time 3. The dynamics of these relationships are illustrated in figure 6 and 7. So basically in this example and this explanation, they discuss the three variables which they measured on different times. Time 1 they measured surface intervening variable, time 2 they measured organization effectiveness and time three, the major dynamics of different relationships. This figure explains the relationship between variables that we discussed in previous slide. For example, time one, the major workforce diversity, which is independent variable. Time two, the major creative synergy, which is intervening variable. And time three, organization effectiveness, which is dependent variable. And this is an example of the intervening and moderating variable. Basically, three or four variables that we discuss in the start of the chapter. The figure discusses that four variables. Here, workforce diversity is independent variable, managerial expertise is moderating variable, creative synergy is mediating and intervening variable, and organization effectiveness is dependent variable. Now, what is theoretical framework? Having examined the different kinds of variables that could create in a situation and how the relationships among these can be established, it is now possible to see how can develop the conceptual model or the theoretical framework for our research. And basically, with the help of theoretical framework, we can explain the relationship, we can explain the logic, how and why two variables are related with each other. The theoretical framework is a foundation on which the entire research project is based. It is a logically developed, described, and elaborated network of associations among the variables deemed relevant to the problem situation. So basically, theoretical framework is helpful a tool which help us to explain the relationship between variables that we are investigating in our research. The components of theoretical framework: the variables considered relevant to study should be clearly defined. Conceptual model that describes the relationship between the variables is the model should be given. So conceptual model should be given in the theoretical framework, a clear explanation of why we expect these relationships. So basically, there are three components of the theoretical framework. Number one is variable that should be clearly defined. Number two, conceptual model that should also be given. And with the help of conceptual model, we can explain the relationships between our in our conceptual model, a theoretical framework. Number three, a clear explanation should also be given for the expected relationships. The relationship between literature survey and the theoretical framework. The literature survey provides a solid foundation for developing the theoretical framework, and the literature survey identifies the variables that might be important as determined by the previous research. So basically, a literature survey helps to provide the foundation, helps us to provide what is done in the topic, in the chapter, something like that. The relationship between literature and theoretical framework. Theoretical framework elaborates the relationship among the variables, explains the theory underlying these relationships, and describes the nature and direction of the relationship. So theoretical framework help us to explain the relationship between variables, between explains and identify the underlying theory, which helps to explain the direction of the relationships. The theoretical framework provides a logical base of developing testable hypotheses, and theoretical framework is also help us to establish the testable relationship between variables, which is also called hypotheses. Interjecting the intervening variables to the model, you may say that lack of adequate training makes the pilots nervous and difficult, and this in turn explains why they are not able to confidently handle situations in MIDR when many aircraft share the skies. Nervousness and defiance are a function of lack of training, and help to explain why inadequate training would result in air safety hazard. This scenario can be depicted in a figure. So, poor training as a moderating variable, we may change the model by using poor training. So here is poor training. A training is a moderating variable, so we can differentiate the relationship between two variables. It depends on the training. The performance of pilots depends on the training. Means training here is a moderator variable. So training may make the relationship weaker. A training may make the relationship stronger between two variables. We are theorizing that poor communication, poor coordination, and decentralization are likely to result in air safety violations only in such cases where the pilot in charge has had inadequate training. This is another example of the moderating variable. Define the problem and develop the critical framework for following situation. The probability of cancer victims successfully recovering under treatment was studied by a medical researcher in hospital. She found three variables to be important in recovery. So this is the practice. This text help us to make the model. Exercise early and correct diagnosis by the doctor. Number one. Number two, the nurse's careful follow-up of the doctor's instructions. And number three, peace and quiet in the vicinity. Exercise in a quiet atmosphere. The patient rested well and recovered sooner. Patients who are admitted in advanced stages of cancer did not respond to treatment, even though the doctor diagnosis was performed immediately on arrival. The nurses did their best and there was plenty of peace and quiet in the area. Thus, stage of cancer is a moderating variable. Also, we could see the patient rest as intervening variables. So basically, these are the examples of the moderating and intervening variables. Hypothesis. Hypothesis is a proposition that is empirically testable. It is empirical statement concerned with the relationship among variables. Hypothesis can be directional and non-directional. Directional means ki some hypotheses have a direction. There is a direction between different hypotheses. In different hypotheses, for example, we can say that there is a relationship between job performance and salary. This is a non-directional hypothesis. If we can say that there is a positive relationship between salary increase and job performance, this is directional hypothesis. Features of a good hypothesis. A hypothesis must be conceptually clear. All the concepts used in the hypothesis must be clearly defined. So number one feature is hypothesis should be conceptually clear. Means ki we conceptually hypothesis should be clear and the concept used in hypotheses, for example, we used concepts in hypotheses, salary increase and job performance, that should be clearly defined. A hypothesis must be empirically testable. So this is another feature. Hypothesis should be empirically testable. Concepts which do not have empirically basis must not be included in the hypothesis. So hypothesis should be empirically testable. Anything you include which is not testable, that might not define the hypothesis. Number third, a hypothesis must be specific and precise. The possible relationship among the variables must be precisely stated in the hypothesis. So if we say that the relationship, there is positive relationship between supervisor behavior and job performance, this is a directional hypothesis and clear, we can test this hypothesis. A hypothesis should be consistent with the known facts. A hypothesis must have a theoretical orientation. So as we have discussed in previous slides, there should be a theoretical backing which explains the relationship between variables. So a definition of the feature of hypothesis is theoretical orientation. A good hypothesis must be able to support or refute an existing theory of social relationships. Hypothesis must be clear, definite, and stated in a simple manner. Hypothesis must have a reasonable explanation to any problem in the present state of knowledge. Hypothesis development, definition of hypothesis. Hypothesis is a logical relationship between two or more variables expressed in the form of testable statements. So this is a definition of hypothesis. Hypothesis should be logical and more variable expressed in the form of testable statements. Statements of hypothesis formats. If then statements can be used to test whether there are difference between two groups. If takes two forms, employees who are more healthy will take sick leave less frequently. This is a type of hypothesis. If employees are more healthy, then they will take sick leaves less frequently. We can test these hypotheses easily. Directional and non-directional hypotheses. Directional, the direction of the relationship between the variables, positive and maybe negative, which is indicated. One of the example of the directional hypotheses, there is a positive relationship between user supervision and turnover intention. This is one of the example of directional hypothesis. The greater the stress experienced in the job, the lower the job satisfaction. This is another example of directional hypothesis. Non-directional hypothesis, there are no indication of the direction of the relationship. For example, jobs in salary and performance are related with each other, but direction is not given in this hypothesis statement. Example, there is a relationship between age and satisfaction. So in this example, there is no direction given. Okay, there is a difference between the work ethic value of America and Arabian employees. There is no direction given in this hypothesis. Null and alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis is a proposition that states a perfect exact relationship between two variables. It states that the population correlation between two variables is equal to zero, some extent number. So in the null hypothesis, the proposition states the perfect relationship between two variables. An alternate hypothesis is the opposite of null hypothesis, is a statement expressing a relationship between two variables. So this is an exercise you people also you people should exercise and try to establish hypotheses. This will help you to understand how to develop the hypotheses, even the hypotheses. So in this exercise, in this figure, is service quality is independent variable, switching cost is moderating variable, customer switching is dependent variable. So we can make hypotheses of these variables easily. Give the hypothesis for the following framework: service quality, customer satisfaction, customer switching. So this is another example of the intervening variable, mediating variables. So we can also establish hypotheses of these variables. After formulating a null and alternate hypothesis, appropriate statistical tests, e-test, f-test can be applied, which would indicate whether or not support has been found of these variables. So after stating the hypothesis and collecting the data, we can test the hypothesis using different statistical tools, and then we can say that the hypothesis is supported, the hypothesis is not supported. Example, a production manager is concerned about the low output level of his employees. The articles that has read on job performance mentioned four variables as important to job performance: skill required for the job, reward, motivation, and satisfaction, and several articles, it was indicated that only one, if the reward were attractive, did motivation, satisfaction, and job performance increase and not otherwise. So here they discuss four variables: motivation, satisfaction, job performance, and skills required. So in this way, we can make the hypotheses and test these hypotheses easily. Given the above situation, do the follow, define the problem, evolve a theoretical framework, and develop at least six hypotheses. Problem statement: how can job performance of the employees be increased through enriched jobs and rewards? So one is that one. This is example of the problem statement. Hypothesis from previous example. So this is the example of the hypothesis which they made using exercise. So you people should also try to establish a hypothesis following the exercise. Thank you, Ji. This is our chapter about theoretical framework and hypotheses. If you have question, you can discuss with me through WhatsApp and through email. Thank you.